In this tutorial, we will guide you through the entire design process of second-order direct analysis using string NIDA and demonstrate the leaning column paradox being unable to design the leaning column. First, this figure shows the leaning column portal. The beam is continuous and the center column is pinned at the two ends. The last column has a rigid end. This layout is quite common for portal frames, except the wrapped beam is flat here for simplicity. If a structure's first member yielding occurs within 10 times the magnitude of the original loads, then the structure is classified as sway sensitive. To determine whether the portal frame is, say, sway sensitive or not, we must first compute the buckling load factor represented by the alpha critical. We may compute for the value by hand calculations or by NIDA built-in function. For our model, the frame is classified as sway sensitive. To demonstrate the concept of the effective length paradox of a lean column, the same model is subject to different materials or different sections may have different sway sensitivity. Our current model, model 2, as you can see, if subject to certain materials or stronger sections, can be classified as non-sway. However, for our case, we have classified as sway sensitive, and the middle column has an infinite numbers for effective length factor k. We found that to be the case by using the graph of the effective length factor to set up a nonlinear analysis case. Analysis hits set analysis case at nonlinear analysis set total load cycle to 100 and target load factor as 1. Make sure that numerical method is set to Newton-Raphson method for constant loads, increments for constant loads, increments. Okay. Click run. On the Apply Load tabs, make sure that all your load cases are being moved to the Load Applied panel on the right. Seems that the program has finished its computation. Make sure the nonlinear analysis case is selected. Now double click the middle column to view its session capacity results. The session capacity factor is 0.57 at the last cycle of the loads cycle, which means that the middle column has reached only half the session capacity at the end of the cycle. In order to find its buckling load, we shall increase either the cycle numbers to 200 or to increase the target load factor to 2 while increasing the number of cycle double its computation time. Increasing the target load factor does not, so we'll set the load cycle back to 100 to save time. Now run again. Now double click the same middle column. It seems that the session capacity factor have reached 1 at the 87th cycle. It seems that the session capacity factor had reached 1 at exactly 87th load cycle. The buckling loads of the middle column is therefore 2272. We may also show the session capacity factor along the load cycle with color. To do that, hit member session capacity factor for reference of the color codes. The red on both sides means the session capacity factor have reached 1. The colder the color is, the less session capacity factor is being reached by the members. To speed up the animations, use these slides. To play the animations, click Play Animations. To show the value of the session capacity factor during the animations, hit this box. On a more advanced level, one may find out the yielding points of the structure by examining the deflection curve. To do that, click this button. On note 5, the deflection curve is being shown. Yielding has not occurred yet, since yielding often follows by extensive deflection behavior. Extends our load cycle to help locate the yielding points of the structure. To do that, we go back to the analysis case, set the load cycle to 200 and the target load factor to 7 to ensure the yielding occurs within the load cycle. Hit run. Click the animation button. The animation have shown what appears to have a yielding occurs indicates by its large exponential deflections occur around the cycle 170. It seems the yielding by clicking the member by clicking the low deflection curved hits 5.5. It seems that the yielding has occurred around these locations at load factor between 6 and 5. This concludes the second order direct analysis.